When we had No Child Left Behind, for the most part, that was based solely on student achievement on a state assessment exam. Now, when we talk ESSA, or the Every Student Succeeds Act, we're now talking a more holistic view of students. So that's also not only state assessments and their achievement, but also their students' growth. We also discuss chronic absenteeism. We also have what's considered to be on-track measures, college and career readiness. There are 6 indicators that students have to have had achieved at grade 5, at grade 8, and then 8 indicators at grade 11 for students to show that they have been exposed to college and career readiness indicators as well. The school district has learned that we have 5 schools identified. We have 3 comprehensive support and intervention schools, also known as CSI. We have 2 additional intervention and support schools, and those are ATSI schools. Our 3 CSI schools are Downey, Roland Academy, and John Harris Campus of Harrisburg High School. Our 2 ATSI schools are Scott Elementary School and Foose Elementary School. If a school is identified as ATSI, that's a school that had 1 subgroup that was identified as not meeting academic or growth measures or on-track measures during that previous academic year. Or they may have also had challenges with chronic absenteeism, meaning that students missed 6 days or more throughout a 60-day consecutive enrollment time within the school district. A school that has been considered to be a comprehensive school and an intervention school is one that, basically put, is the bottom 5% of Title I schools within the state. Because the identification is very new, the Department of Education for the state of Pennsylvania will be providing intensive support for the CSI schools, and what that plan is ongoing and will be built in collaboration with the group who will be coming from PDE. The ATSI schools will be receiving supports from the Capital Area Intermediate Unit, and their plan gets built in collaboration with those as well. As a part of ESSA, those plans will be due sometime within the next several months. We've always had by race, African-American, Caucasian, Asian, Pacific Islander, Hispanic, economically disadvantaged, which for the city of Harrisburg, 85% of our children are economically disadvantaged. Also, special education, which is new, but now with a much greater focus. ELLs are English language learners. That is also a new group that the state has focused on, because we know that oftentimes with our L students, they can learn social English very well, but can struggle with the academic English. We know that from what we learned from the state, that comprehensive school improvement schools will also receive some additional funds from PDE. What those funds will be at this time, we are not aware. ATSI schools will not receive additional funds. We do not know if that will be something that may change, as the state has identified targets for each school from here until the ultimate fruition of the plan in 2030. The targets are achievable. Each of our schools have targets somewhere between 3 to 3.5% each year. As we stress with our educators, both in-classroom teachers, support, building, and district administrators, that the key is exposure to students and core content, core learning, meaning on grade level teaching every day, providing the accommodations that students need, and providing the appropriate interventions. We require all teachers to have is a classroom management plan. We have proactive strategies to be able to deal with students who may present behavioral challenges. We know that students every day are learning more about themselves. They're learning what does it mean to be a student, whether that's for their first time entering a kindergarten or they're a senior at our SciTech campus.